He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
So I'm talking to, you know, I'm asking some questions, and I asked Lil Mama. She had to be, I don't know, somebody got to help me out. If you are in the third grade, you probably like 8. I'm not too far off, right? I was like, Lil Mama, I got to ask you a question, because, you know, you might not like school, but I want to give you a reason to like it. Who do you love the most? She's like, I love my mama. Third grade, 8 years old. I'm just making an assumption. Somebody helping me out. I'm thinking she gonna say she wanna do what for her mom when she grow up. Does somebody take a wild guess? What I'm thinking she gonna say, not what she actually said. Buy her house. Good. What else did I think she was gonna say? A car. Yeah. I love it. Lil Mama said, I wanna move my mom into a white neighborhood so she can be safe. I said, boom. Let's go. Expect no third grader to say no mess like that. She kept it 100. I want to move my mom into a white neighborhood so she can be safe. I'm like, bet, let's go. She said, then I want to make enough money so I can move my family here and I don't have to deal with no more drama. I said, what you know about drama at 8 years old? Enough of it to make it a dream. So from now on, when you come to school, I don't care if you hate your teacher. I want you to think about your mama being in a safe neighborhood. I told you before, that's what I'm hoping you're gonna do for me. I'm hoping you're gonna come up with something that's gonna make you get your lazy butt up. I can't wait till you come up with something that's gonna make you stop oversleeping. I can't wait till you wake up with something that's gonna make you grind like you've never grinded before and to make the kind of money you wanna make, live where you wanna live, drive. I'm still upset that you ain't found that thing within that's pushing you to do what you wanna do. You might need to go sit down with that little girl in school. So when you go to school every day from this point forward, it ain't math. It's putting your mom in a safe neighborhood. And that's what we talk about today. If you're gonna do what you say you're gonna do, be what you say you're gonna be, you're gonna have to lion me out. That gazelle stuff, I'm trying to tell you. You a gazelle, you're gonna come up short. You a gazelle, you're not always gonna get what you want out of life. You a gazelle, you're gonna have an average experience. You a student, I need you in lion mode. You a teacher, I need you in lion mode. You an entrepreneur, I need you in lion mode. You trying to lose weight, lion mode. You can't do nothing significant in gazelle mode, nothing. Nothing impressive happens in gazelle mode. Nothing happen when you running. Nothing happen in run mode, give up mode, quit mode, scared mode, fearful mode, nothing happens. Everything happen in lion mode like I'm coming to get you. I love it. Y'all ever seen the one where the lioness is kind of sitting there and she double dutching and all the beasts is running by and they just keep going. And she just in preparation mode. And out of nowhere, there is no music, no preparation. You just see my man come out of nowhere and just boom, bam, grab one, boom, boom, rip the heart out. That's lion mode. And you got to get to a place where you start executing. Somebody just help me out. Last year, the greatest news in the NBA, the greatest story in the NBA last year was what? Greatest story told in the NBA last year, offseason, was what? Kevin Durant left to go to Golden State. Durant like, I'm out. I don't know where y'all come from, but that hurt hard because they supposed to be boys. Look at this picture for a minute. Because this is why, if you're gonna be successful, this is where I need you to go right here. What a pick. This was the one where you play your boy first game, you and your homie was cool, right? And this is where you emotionally cut him. This when you cut my man. This when you see my man and he trying to be cool. He trying to act like he ain't leave you high and dry. He trying to act like the goals and the dreams y'all have. This the one where he clapping and you look my man in his face and say, you dead to me. And that's why most of you will never be successful, because there's some stuff in your past you keep holding on to. And you got to get to a point when you're ready to grind and you're ready to get to the next level. You look at people you used to be close to and say, you dead to me. You dead. 42 triple doubles. We shouldn't even be talking about the MVP. Ain't nobody else even. If somebody else make it close to the MVP, the NBA is rigged and I'm through with them. They saw my man at the beginning of the season. I'm talking about high octane. They said if he keep doing that all season, what's gonna happen? They said he keep running himself like that, he's gonna burn out. My man ain't burnt out. He don't look like, he ain't close to burn out. But you know why they said it? Because they can't operate on that level for that long. So people will try to put their limitations on you.
I can do 6 gigs. I can do 7. We can leave here tonight. You can take me to a church. I'll give you another hour. You can't do it. Don't put your limitations on me. I'm dead to your limitations. Your limitations don't exist in my world. Those are your limitations. Keep them. Go home, watch them on TV. Go home, read the newspaper about. Go home and look in the mirror. Go home, call your homeboy, and y'all talk about your limitations. I ain't got none. I get off the plane from going to Dubai and get on the ground, and I hit it. And some of y'all holding on to stuff you shouldn't be holding on to. It should be dead to you. Doggone, go do a funeral if you need to. Get rid of that junk. Like, bury it. Do whatever you got to do. But it's weighing you down. It's killing you. Every day you waking up thinking about it. You shouldn't be thinking about it no more. It should be dead to you. Move on. And move towards your greatness. I forget those things which are behind. And I press. I press towards the thing. I press. I don't got time for that no more. It's nothing personal. I ain't got nothing against you. I don't hate you, but I love me.